Hi, everybody. I'm Rob Jolliffe. This is a Sabre Limited Expert Series. We took a break during the fall, but we're back and we're going to be bringing you some more great Expert Series videos. So let's get into this one. All right. So today's Expert Series video is going to be on Business Central user types. I'm going to try and explain Business Central user types to you. Those of you who are looking at Business Central, this is always confusing. My name is Rob Jolliffe. I am president of Sabre Limited. We're a Business Central manufacturing focused partner, servicing the entire North American continent and pretty much any English speaking part of the world. A couple of quick notes about this. I am always sort of focused on manufacturing and in particular the small and medium business manufacturing. So, I'm assuming that that's who's watching the video, but it's relevant to people in other types of industries as well and can give you some good information. If you'd like to talk to me, there's a link to my, Calendly. So you can set up a half an hour appointment with me. If you'd like to just put in some questions that you want asked, I can help you answer questions, about this video or other videos that you may have seen and maybe give you a little bit of information about Business Central and how it works, for manufacturing companies. Okay. So I'm going to start off with one of the big questions, which was, what is the difference between Business Central Essentials and Premium? So the Essentials and Premium is actually pretty easy. This is the easy part because the Premium includes two extra features that are not in Essentials, the production orders and management features and the service orders and management. So production orders are your typical volume manufacturing, cookie cutter, repetitive manufacturing process. You make a widget, you have a bill of material, you have a routing, you create purchase or production orders to make those widgets. You might have 50 or 100 different widgets you make. They have work centers and cost centers that they have to go through. So the production orders allow you to create that along with their routing. Service orders are designed for outside services that are provided usually at the customer site. It could be something where you're servicing it and repairing it in your own facility, but typically service orders are meant for parts that are being sent out or staff who are going to be sent out into the field and they're going to service something in the field. The service orders are built around the idea that you have items in the field that you service and that you can create the orders, you can bill for them, and you can even create them in advance through contracts and different kinds of arrangements you have with the client. So those are the two features that are in the Business Central Premium. Essentials has absolutely everything else. All of the inventory, all of the accounting, all of the jobs, the assemblies, the core capability, sales, purchasing, all of those capabilities are in Essentials. Only those two features are added to Premium. The other big difference is that Premium is 42% more expensive than Essentials. So we're talking $100 for a Premium license versus $70 for an Essentials license. So you can think of Essentials as 30% cheaper than Premium, or Premium is 42% more expensive than Essentials, depending on which way you're looking. I will mention one more thing. All of your users have to be the same. So you cannot mix and match Essentials and Premium users in the same subscription, which generally means the same tenant, which is the same domain name. So if you have, if you're acmeinc.com, you can't have some Premium and some Essentials at acmeinc.com. You'd have to create another company in Office 365, at least as far as I know. All right, let's talk about the difference between the team, the full, and the device licenses. So there's three types of licenses. Once you've picked whether you want your Essentials or your Premium, now you're down to these license types. So team members. Just think of team members as read only. That's your safest bet. They are read only. They can't really do much. Now that's not true, but it's the best way to think about them. The other thing team members are, you could think of them as, is they are the add-on, third-party add-on product add-on users. So team members can read and write from a fairly large number of add-on tables during their sessions. So they read write into specific tables, but they're read only most everywhere else with the limit that they can edit things. So team members can edit existing data and they can add data to customization tables. So now we're getting into this. It's getting more and more complex. But essentially, think of a team member as read-only. They really can do very little, but they can update information somebody else already created. So if there was a customer created, they could change their address. If there was a production job created, they could change the quantity. They have some limited capabilities, but they're very, very limited in what they can do. Okay, so obviously the full user is the other user type. So the team members, by the way, are $8 US per month. So versus that $100 or $70 I mentioned earlier, they're very cheap. The full users are that full price. They're $100 for premium or $70 for an essentials. And the full users can post. And posting is a really specific thing in Business Central. It means that something has changed inventory value. Something is going to change a GL account somewhere. By the way, when you change inventory, you're changing a GL account because your inventory exists in your GL as an asset. So if you're doing something that changes any dollars in the accounting side of Business Central, which, by the way, if I post a receipt for a purchase order, if I post a shipment for a sales order, if I post the receipt of a check, if I post the movement of inventory from one location to another location, all of those things have an inventory or a sales or a purchase subledger effect, which affects the GL, which means you need a full user. Full users can create rows. Now, you'll recall when I was talking about team members, they can edit things that have been created by a full user. So the full users can create things, which means they're the people who can create new customers or vendors or items or new purchase orders or new sales shipments. So these are the pretty significant tasks that need to be done. And it's usually pretty good to assume that most users who are going to be working in the ERP all day are going to be full users. It's pretty rare you can get away without that. There's a few exceptions. Okay, device license. Basically, a device license is for a device, but it's also a license that's intended to allow someone to do something a full user could do on a device someplace where multiple people are going to be using that computer. So it is not to be used as a substitution for a full user. I'll talk about that in a second, but I'll tell you what you are specifically supposed to use it for. So typically, it's supposed to go in some common use location where multiple people will be using the same computer for multiple functions. And it's limited, and it's actually written in Microsoft's licensing agreement that you are going to sign when you sign for Business Central, that it's for inventory management transactions, like what a warehouse person would do, driving their tow motor around and moving inventory around. Shop floor data collection, which would be perhaps quality data or production quantities produced or scrap materials. Reporting production or time. It's kind of related to the shop data, but it could be also for reporting the time of service order technicians doing service technician work, or engineers working on engineering drawings on a job, or any of those sorts of transactions. Point of sale devices, such as you'd see in a retail shop or at a cash and carry, so basically cash registers, and websites or portals. I may have missed something. If I missed something, you can go ahead and write it in the comments below, but I'm pretty sure those are the main areas, and you technically therefore cannot use it for other purposes. You can't use it to replace a full user. If you decided, oh, I have a device, Joe sits at the device all day, he does sales orders, he does purchase orders, I'm going to give Joe a device user license for his device, that is in violation of the Microsoft licensing agreement. It might work, it probably won't, but if you manage to make it work, you'd still be in violation of the license agreement, and there's pretty hefty fines if you're found in violation of that. Okay. So the last thing I'm going to try and deal with is who needs to be a full user, because customers are always confused by that as well. I've kind of explained who can and can't, what they can and can't do, but they often want to know, but what does that mean? Like, I have people, I have staff. Who needs to be a full user? All right, your purchasing department, people who are doing purchasing, they need to be full users. Anybody who creates items, vendors, or customers, they need to be a full user. Anyone entering sales orders needs to be a full user. So that could be an inside salesperson, but not an outside. The outside salesperson with a team license could go look up sales orders, could even edit them, but couldn't create new ones. Now, one thing I didn't mention about team members is team members can create quotes, which is not often done, but it's a thing that sometimes happens. Anyone creating a production order, an assembly order, or a job needs to be a full user. Everyone in accounting needs to be a full user. Now, just a little aside to the accounting, sometimes we have the HR department and the accounting department are kind of like mixed together, and the person who does payroll is considered part of the accounting department. Payroll is a little different. Payroll is almost always done through add-ons in Business Central. There is no Microsoft payroll system that's built in. So you get an add-on, and as you recall, the team members can act as add-ons in some cases, but they can't post. So if that payroll person's going to post payroll, which affects the value in the general ledger, then they need to be a full user. Usually some of your engineers, but not necessarily all of them, the ones who are going to create items or bills of material, they need to be full users. Your shipper, your receiver, anybody who's managing inventory, the asterisk is because there are some add-on products that allow you to use device licenses for some of this. But as a general rule of thumb, I would assume your shipper and receiver and anybody who's managing inventory, like they're doing cycle counts and they're responsible for adjustments, would have to be a full user. It's just really overall, it's best to talk to someone if you're looking at Business Central and you want a really accurate count. And typically, I would just assume that people need to be full users if you're unsure. I hope you really liked this video and that it was helpful to you. Please subscribe and follow our channel and maybe recommend this to other people who might be investigating Business Central. I'm going to try and start doing new videos weekly again, at least for the winter season and maybe into early spring. But thank you very much, everybody. If you'd like to contact us, we're at www.sabrelimited.com. You can email and I will receive it at sales@sabrelimited.com. And you can find me on LinkedIn at Rob Jolliffe. Thanks very much. Have a great day.